teaching of it in here. Women are also commanded to be obediently submissive and respectful to their own husbands. And guess what? That submitting goes both ways. If you read your Bible, wives submit and husbands submit as well. Peter adds that they were to cultivate a gentle and quiet spirit that was beautiful to God and immense value in the marriage. This was to be a reciprocal relationship of a godly marriage. But soon, listen, let me tell you something.
Go ahead.
Your church membership, your church leadership, your church fellowship is nothing if your Christ relationship is out of order. If you don't have God in your heart, if you're not living according to His word, you can forget about any other one, because that relationship has to be intact first in order for every other relationship to work. And so when I think about marriage is an honorable institution established by God. God said it is not His will that man should be alone. So He created women. And let me tell you, marriage is the building block of society. Where there are strong marriages, there will be strong communities and strong families and strong church. But don't you know the devil has set out to destroy the marriage? Because if he can destroy the marriage, he will have destroyed society. But I want to encourage every woman in here and every man in here, you ought to have a godly relationship. Oh yes, we need mothers to teach young women how to be wives, how to be good mothers. I'm going to say this and I'm going to leave it alone. A lot of what's going on with our children, we're losing an entire generation. Why? Because they see too much. Amen. They hear too much. Amen. The world is not hurting them. They're being hurt right in the house. They're being molested right in the house. They're being abused right in the house. They see you letting some man go upside your head in the house. They see you letting go in and out of your house like it's a swinging door. Let me tell you, you've got to be more godly. I'm not judging, but I'm preaching God's word. That's in the book. And if you say you're a godly woman, you ought to be living a godly lifestyle. They go from men to. And so as I get ready to close, this is about the mother's ministry today. And I want to encourage our mother's ministry. We're counting on you. Don't give up on us. We're counting on you. You've got to encourage not only the young women, but you've got to encourage all of us to do better. I don't know, but it's something about the faith of a mother. And even as we approach Mother's Day, when we're talking about our biological mothers, there's something different about that relationship. A mother, just the fact of saying that word ought to mean something. And if somebody can call you mother, be it a church mother or be it a biological mother, that is a position of honor. And there's something about a mother. Let me tell you, I'll be the first to tell you, as men, we fumble the ball. We drop the ball sometimes. But praise God for the women in the family, the women in the church who have undergirded, and where we have fallen, they have stepped up to the plate. And that's why on Second Sundays, on Youth Sundays, when we have altar call, I don't do that prayer. Why? I like to have a mother pray. It's something about when a mother prays for her children. And so likewise, I want to encourage the church mothers today. We are spiritual children of God, but you are the matriarch of the house. And it's something powerful when you find a woman of faith. It's something powerful when mothers pray. How many of you know feverish children wake up well? When mothers pray, a judge sitting on a bench will change his mind. When mothers pray, how many of you know husbands are to find their way home? When mothers pray, the money will stretch. When mothers pray, loneliness evaporates. When mothers pray, dilemmas are dissolved. When mothers pray, the ugly turns into beautiful. When a mama pray, the worst gives way to the best. When mothers pray, poor gives way to hope. When mothers pray, kidnapped children are found. When mothers pray, what's bad becomes good. When mothers pray, what's There's something about when a mother prays.
Yes.
And I want to encourage not just a church mother, but all mothers, don't give up. You got to stay in there. We may not act right all the time, but you stay on your post. Stay loving them. Stay chasing them. Stay in with as a woman of integrity. Don't give up with us. Don't give up on us. Don't throw in the towel, but you got to be patient with us. Hold on until the change comes. Keep on praying. Don't turn your back on us. And don't turn your back on God. When things start pressing you down, I dare you to pray. The songwriter wrote, when mama bowed her head and knelt down in fervent prayer, she knew how to call on the name of Jesus, because she knew that he would meet her there. She prayed for help and for strength so that she can run the Christian race. But she never, ever, never, ever, never failed to pray for her children, saying, Lord, save them by your grace. And I just come out here to tell you, it's about the grace of God that's going to bring any change. It's the grace of God that's going to bring healing. It's the grace of God that's going to help us to act right. And I'm so glad about his grace that traveled across 42 generations, that died on the cross, but didn't stay dead, because early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. And mothers, you had power to lay hands on the children. You had power to influence the young. You had power to help us along the way. Our matriarch. It amazes me. I thought about it. As I look at churches, United is it's just like any other church. We have a mother's board. But I notice we have a mother's board, but there's no father's board. Have you ever thought about that? There's a mother's board, but there's no father's board. I just believe that it's just designed like that. You know, it's something about the persuasions of a woman. The persuasions of a mother. Persuasions of a wife.
Yes, yes.
Daughter, women, you are important to us.
Yes, yes.
We can't be born without you. It's hard to live with you sometimes. But we can't live without you. I thank God. I'm a blessed man. I had a loving mother. Loving grandmother. Still got my other loving grandmother. Got a loving wife. God, I can't even count how many loving aunts I have. And I praise God for my daughter. Amen. Women, you are precious to us.
Yeah.
But you're vital to our families. You're vital to our society. That's why we might as well get ready. I don't know what the future holds, but if it happened like I think it, we're gonna have a woman residing in D.C. I'm just saying, you know, for what I see. So you're vital in the family, you're vital in society, and you're vital here in the church.
Yes.
We need you.
Yes.
We need you to be our matriarchs. Amen. 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 Somebody may be here today. Outside of the ark of safety, that means that you have never accepted Christ in the free pardon of your sins. That if the Lord will come back, you will find yourself not ready. And if you are here today and you've never accepted Christ, we want to extend an invitation to you that you'll be able to come and receive him, that your life will be changed. And guess what? When you accept him and his Holy Spirit take up residence in you, you'll be able to show someone else the way. You'll be able to train somebody along the way. You'll be able to nurture somebody along the way. The doors of the church are open. Is there one? Is there one?
Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus.
He will.